At 1:30, we'll call the meeting to order with a moment of silence. Okay, thank you. Need to approve the agenda?
Move to approve.
Support.
Move the second to approve the agenda. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. We had a addition, your co-line to approve their fireworks application. Looks like they got their fire chief to sign off on that. Looking to put them, shoot them off on August 1st. We need a motion to approve.
Move to approve their request.
Support.
Okay, it's been moved and seconded to approve the request for the application for co-line. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Motion carries. The Rolling Oldies want to use the restrooms on July 25th.
Is that correct? Is that right, Saturday?
That's Saturday, yes. Yeah.
I thought about it later. I didn't know.
That's this Saturday.
Okay.
And Troy's going to be gone. I told Troy I'd take care of him for him. So I'll be around. So move to approve the request.
Support.
Okay. All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed? Motion carries. All right. Number five is going to come up, and there's some folks who wanted to speak from the public ahead of our discussion. So I put on the agenda for right now to take public comments. If anybody would like to make a public comment, just come up to the chair. Give us your statements.
So introduce myself and just say
sure. Right. Go ahead.
I'm Dan Labott. I'm Director of Behavioral Health. And I understand that you guys are going to have discussion today about making decisions related to the regionalization of mental health services. And I've kind of taken a look at some of the different options available, and I've talked with Jay, the director of the hospital, and Aaron, the executive director. As far as from our perspective and the position that we see ourselves in mental health wise, we're kind of leaning towards the direction of maybe going south to that group, that three county group with that Wapello is a part of. Just looking at, we share some of the same patients already. The people are coming back and forth from those counties. We've worked with them in other ways and other capacities as far as collaborating for services. Just see that they have similar like demographics that we do, kind of the same philosophies about how the people are served. Could see a lot of pros and benefits in that direction in particular. Not necessarily anything wrong with the group to the north, other than it's larger numbers, and I feel like some more creative planning could happen with the smaller numbers as well.
But there's also the possibility of a bigger region you can do. I mean, they're talking about some jail diversion stuff up there and some really cool things, I think.
I think the south is too, actually. Yeah. I was looking at their plan and talking with, and in just different meetings that I've been at, some of the things that they're doing. We've used their Centerville house in the past, and it was really a neat, slick use, easy access for our patient. They worked really well with us on that also. So, you know, have some things that I think that we could helpful. I mean, I would see that we are a strong county as far as our mental health services, that you know, we would be a strong benefit to them as well as, so we'd have a lot to offer them as well as what they might have to offer us also. And that, given that, that's if we would make the decision that we don't take it further with the state and try to appeal that decision that they had made as well. That was all I have. So I guess I just think that we as a county are in a really attractive position in some ways to make some good decisions and really want to look at where we can position ourselves that allows us to achieve the outcomes we want to achieve, which is we want to have mental health access for all of our citizens.
Would that not be achieved in going to the north?
I think it could, but I think the most attractive from our perspective is going south. You know, I don't think it wouldn't happen going to the north, but I just think going south is the most attractive as far as being able to have more of a voice, I guess. And that's, and I don't have any facts to prove that. I came from the Waterloo area before I moved here about 5 years ago and was in that larger group up there. Worked in Waterloo, worked in that larger community. Of course, those people got the most attention and the outlying counties didn't have as much voice and access to some of the supports and services, it felt like a lot of times. I know they work hard not to allow that to happen, but unfortunately I see it happen that way.
Would your, personally, or Behavioral Health Services as an entity prefer one way or the other that we appeal the decision or that we move forward with trying to find a contiguous region?
I don't know that the hospital has a super strong opinion that way. Jay's response to me is I want us to just have a thoughtful, make a thoughtful decision that keeps in mind the outcome we want to have as a community, you know, and as a county. So he says, I don't know that we're in a position that we want to put up a fight, but if we believe that that's the best interest for everybody, then he'd be a part of that.
More questions? Thank you, Jen.
Okay, thanks.
Anybody else wish to speak?
Well, I don't know if I necessarily want to go sit out there, but I do want to get that off of what Jen said as the coordinator of disability services for this county. Being familiar with both meetings that we're discussing, I can tell you that we will have a bigger voice if we go south. We'll be lost if we go north. I also have a very good relationship with the CEO of the southern region. I know a couple people in the northern region, but my experience is with the Waterloo Davis Avenue counties. So from a CVS, Mahaska county standpoint, that would be my preference to go that direction.
Jen?
And maybe just think of one other thing. Just judicially, we work with that court system already also. There's that piece also. And then, you know, one of our primary providers for in-home supporting services for patients without, you know, in their homes, you know, are based out. They have an office here, but they also have an office in the Waterloo area, you know. So that connection is pretty strong there as far as the sharing of
anybody else wish to speak from the public? Okay, we will close the public comments portion. Number five is consider plan in response to the state.
Where is the letter from DHS that they sent us on Friday? When did we receive that?
Huh?
When did we receive that?
I received it, and Mark Ramey received it as chairman of the region when I went over to Knoxville after the board meeting here Monday, and then they're not going to reconsider.
It shouldn't take 2 days for this to get to us, though. I mean, I haven't seen it. It's been sitting here. This is part of the problem we have in our region is communication.
Okay. I'm sorry.
Shouldn't be the first time we have to lay eyes on this kind of stuff. It makes me crazy. I shouldn't have to call DHS and ask them for what they told us.
Okay. Basically what he said. All right.
Okay, so really, what we're looking at, we have a few different options that we can do. I prepared a letter in case we want to appeal the decision of Director Palmer. There is an appeals process, so we can go through the documents for that have been or are in the process of being worked through Marion County. Well, it's actually Ed Bull, who's actually the attorney, also the attorney for the region. I don't know what the status of those are, the appeal documents.
I'm not sure, Ed's working on this, all I know. Mark Ramey is out of town until New York, or until tomorrow, he'll return from New York. And I assume there'll be discussions with Ed probably Friday on that.
So we have that, that is an option. Mike has talked to, I want to make sure I get the name right, Central Iowa Community Services Region, which is 10 counties to the north of us. Includes Jasper and Poweshiek, two that had withdrawn from our previous region. And to go in with them again, with that 10 county region. And so we have three different letters, one that was drafted to the chairman of the region, Mark Ramey, one to Director Palmer, giving him a outline of our plan, and one to the, I believe it's to the region that we would be joining to the north should we decide to go that way. I had an opportunity to talk with Jennifer Vitko yesterday. She's the director of the it's the South Central Behavioral Health Region. Includes Wapello, Appanoose, and Davis County. I also talked to Steve Siegel, who is the chair of the board there, as well as a guy by the name of Neil Smith, who's also an Appanoose County supervisor, to see if that would be a possibility. All of them had indicated that they're open to the idea, but we'd have to go through the application process, pretty much just the same position that we would be in if we went to the CICS region. The other option, we could choose one of those two to go to. I don't know if it is an option, I guess, but one of the other options I think that we can do is look into both regions and ask both of them for input and make a decision going forward based on what we gather. I've looked at both of their 2080s. Both of them look similar. The one to the north, I believe there's a mandatory levy that you have to levy the max that the state allows for, and they pool dollars down to the south. That's not in their 2080. However, that's been their practice the last 2 years that they've levied the max. And so, but it's not part of their 2080. They can lower that in the future.
One of the things that you might want to consider, and I would suggest, it wouldn't hurt to have both of those folks come in and present so that you would have the opportunity to ask questions on how they fund and how their day-to-day operations go and how their region is organized. In the 10-county Central Iowa group, of those 10 counties, there are four of them that are levying 4728, which is the max, and the other six counties are considerably less than that. In the three-county South Central Behavioral Health, Wapello and Davis are at 4728, Appanoose is at 4715, with Mahaska at 4728. You're going to have equal funding if they go per capita, but everybody's got the same amount of per capita, 4728. In the 10 county region, Mahaska would be the fifth of 11. And my understanding is everybody is required to levy their max regardless of what their local need is. It's region wide, everybody levies everything.
The only question I have by looking at both of them in more detail is that he wanted an answer by August 1st or July 31st. And I don't think that we can make that happen before our August meeting. I think a couple of days late probably permissible, but I don't want him to just stick us arbitrarily into a region without us deciding. I think we'd rather make the pick if that's what we're going to do. A couple other things that have come up in the 2080s, both 2080s only allow for entrance into a region after the next fiscal year is over. If we make application, for example, to the one to the south, I believe, by December 1st, they don't actually admit us into the region until July 1st.
I think that's true. I think all the 2080s talk about new members joining.
I'm not sure how we suffice the Director Palmer's wish to have us in there by November 1st if if they will allow us in. So that's, it's going to create a little bit of a, we'll need a clarification from him as to how we do that. To come in compliance with.
Wouldn't our first step be is take a vote whether we're going to appeal or not appeal this? It looks like an obvious thing we should do. Would that, and then go take our discussions from there? We can talk about letters and all this all day, but if we're going to appeal it is one thing. If we're not going to appeal it, then we'll proceed this one.
Depends on what direction we go, whether I'd rather appeal or...
Yeah. I think you have to make the appeal decision first, and then you go from there, personally, but...
If we appeal the letter, we can still be working concurrently. In the appeal letter, I said concurrently, we'll investigate other regions should we not be successful with the appeal, but... I don't think that we have anything to lose by setting up, at least asking for an appeal to the decision.
I think we continue to lose time. I mean, I think it's pretty obvious. The appeal process is going to go through DHS, and I don't see it getting through there.
Doesn't the appeal process go through a department inspection?
The departments of inspections and appeals.
Through an administrative law judge, I think, gives a ruling.
My preference is to go north and not appeal, just to be honest.
My preference is to go south and not appeal. So I talked to this lady down there yesterday, and then Siegel called me last night, and we do, I think as Jan said, we match up with there. And when I came on the board several years ago, we were in a DHS district with Wapello, Mahaska. Worked well until people at the state decided to regionalize. But anyway, we're in the same judicial district. We've worked with these people. I think it's a smaller group. I think it makes sense. To me, it makes sense, regardless of if that's where we're at. That's in weighing these things out. And I'm not opposed to both of those groups making a pitch, whatever. But I guess I've wrestled around with this. And I see the benefit of going south rather than going north.
My preference is to appeal, but if we can't appeal, I can't make a motion, so let's take that one off the table for now.
This is like the legislature, isn't it, Mr. Rosebaum?
No comment.
If we continue to look at both regions, my preference also would be to not appeal if we're not going to, and to go to the south. It seems like we would have more... at least make an application and see how it goes. I think we would have more of a voice, I guess, for our constituents. We share clients there. We share providers there. There's providers that provide services in our county that are stationed out of Wapello County. I think that it makes a lot more sense than being a small fish in a big pond up in the northern region. I don't understand why we would go with two of the counties that had left us already anyhow. I don't know why they left. They didn't give a good reason. We can speculate all day long, but it seems like it'd be more of an amicable relationship to go to the South Central Gator region.
I also don't feel comfortable with both of you being involved, who have been in two failed regions now. We had a four-county, we're working towards a four-county agreement, and it fell through, and there's various reasons. Now we've been working with DHS to get provisional authority for our two-county region, and that fell through. Something needs to change. We can't keep doing it the same way because it's not working. And it's twice now. It's happened. First time maybe it's a fluke, but this appears to be a pattern.
Okay, well, I came on the board in the midst of the first one falling apart, so I guess I can take the blame for that one too. But for this region, I don't think that it's fallen apart. I think that the things that he has outlined in his letter, we've done. There is no corrective action plan that we've needed. We've met all their criteria, so. If that's what you call a failing region, then so be it.
What's their basis for ending our provisional status?
Well, you received the letter, didn't you?
Well, yeah, 5 minutes ago I received the letter.
I'm not asking about that letter, the first letter.
Well, I know, we replied.
That was like a couple weeks ago.
What's their standing status now? I didn't have a chance to pour through it, but what's their?
It just says Palmer, Director Palmer is not going to change his mind.
Right.
And in that letter, it doesn't say that they agree or disagree with what we submitted in our response to their first letter. It just said he's not going to.
I'd rather appeal and go the direction I think we're going.
Why?
I just don't see it as a good fit politically or.
Well, I think, Mike, you have to rely on the people that work in the field a little bit in your decision also, and I think they've given some good reasons for going.
They're also on board with when we were joining Palaszczuk and Wapello or Jasper County. No. They're also on board when we were joining Marion County.
Well, things have changed.
Yeah, I know, but
and
politically, I think, I mean, it isn't an exact fit, but Senator Rosenblum's district goes down into a lot of those. Do you have any of Davis County?
None of Davis,
but Appanoose and Wapello.
No.
So politically, it does match up somewhat. I'd say our politics probably don't line up exactly with but some of it.
Politics aside, I worked with Siegel and Parker down there and over the years we really haven't run into any major confrontations over politics. There's none over politics. It's about what's best for your people. And I think they think the same way. I know what their politics are down there, but that doesn't enter in when we're on DCAT, when we're on empowerment and all those things that I've worked with those guys on. A lot of
the 20AD boards that we already have, I serve with supervisors from a lot of those different counties. Wapello and Greg Kenning and some of the others, Dale Taylor from Davis County.
Outside of a few of them, I don't even know what party most of them are affiliated with. I never asked and I don't care. It's the way it is. So, I guess what my voice is, I think the fit is with Wapello County in the south, and I think to appeal it is a waste of time. So that's where I stand. And if you guys vote to appeal it, why, you go for it. I'll be a no vote on that right up front. So.
Move to appeal.
Is there any? I'll second your motion. Do we need to make an amendment to the motion to allow for us to concurrently be working as well with a, should this not go through in my letter, we can always take that provision out. But do we need to start having talks in case it doesn't go our way so we're not losing time? I guess I would amend your motion, or I'd ask for you to amend your motion to allow us to work concurrently with other regions that are around us. That's my motion. If we're going to do that, I need to second.
What's up?
I said, that's my motion, if we're, for an amendment, it needs a second, otherwise it'll die. The motion to amend has died. The motion on the table is that we appeal their decision. It's been motioned and seconded. Any further discussion? All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
Opposed?
Aye. Where we're at, I'm opposed to it, I guess. Is that the motion now?
Yeah.
Or the amendment?
That was the motion.
Okay.
The amendment.
Okay.
Have a second. So we'll appeal their decision.
So where does that leave us then? All this is just waits and we're gonna appeal?
There can be another motion that we would start looking for, looking into the regions around us, or if you want to start looking to the south, that can be a motion.
Be pretty hard to put in your appeal letter to wherever you're appealing to that, well, we're also in the process of trying to join up with somebody else. I mean, you're either in or you're out on this thing, it looks to me like, until the appeal's over.
Okay.
I don't know.
That would just rectify the problem that we're losing time.
No, you're gonna lose more time yet, so.
All right. The next item on the agenda is to consider appointment to a new region. That will be a moot point. So that's all I have on my agenda. We can
adjourn. Okay.
We can adjourn.
Move to adjourn.
Boarded.
All those in favor say aye.
Aye.
We're adjourned.